2005 was one of the musically most successful years for Paris-born Jackson Fourgeaud, aka Jackson and his computer band. His maxi single Utopia and his radical remix for M83's Run Into Flowers was played by DJs like Ellen Alien, Trevor Jackson, Richie Horton and Giles Peterson. With his debut album Smash on Warp Records, the 27-year-old inspired the electronic music scene around the world. Jackson describes his sound as a musical clash between all kinds of different genres, a style orgy of asynchronous sound fragments from rock, hip-hop, electronic, funk, to classical music. Reason enough to have a relaxing chat with the sound whiz above the roofs of Berlin.
My first techno thrill was like as a teenager, basically hanging out with the weirdest guy from school, like the most, the weirdos, the guys that were into troubles. So they were listening to really intense gabber, and that was really fun. I was very condescending and very kind of, I was playing drums in a band, so I was in this whole process of learning the real music, you know. So that's what I thought. I thought, like, you know, this is not music, this is total crap. And then I started to realize, like, how alien and how space this was, because I had no way of understanding this music. Like, what's the pacing, you know? And and then we took, they took me to raves, like, warehouse raids, taking lots of acid and listening to like gabber and hardcore music, and that was lots of fun. That was really fun. Then I realized, like, for girls it was kind of like a dead end, this whole culture. So then I started to listen to garage and house music. I went through both, so that was cool as well. It was different, it was more about clubbing and stuff, and then I got fed up of this. My first contact with, I think, electric music is this album from Herbie Hancock called Headhunters, where he plays synth, and it's like fusion, jazz, funk, free, you know. And this was like, wow. And then it's full of electric, you know, electrical or synthesis instrument. And, you know, that was a shock, big shock. My first record, EP, like vinyl EP, was in 96. Now we started giving dates, so it's getting very serious. So in 96, I released my first EP with this label Pumpkin, and this was very exciting because I was still at school, and I was just starting to go raving and stuff. And suddenly, my older sister says, "Hey, I've met this old friend in the street, and he's just starting a techno label." And I was like, "Wow! This is near me. I can have access to labels and stuff." I met the guy. I played him some stuff. It was very fast and very aggressive. I think he liked the idea of like me being so young, because when I met him, it was like a bunch of guys. I was 15, so for him it was like, wow, who is this like a young, aggressive teenager? So they really educated me and learned me all the sort of production technique. So that was like, I think, big luck to be in a studio and discover what is a Moog and what is a mixing desk and a compressor and all these things. And then one weekend, they said, oh, the studio is free. Let's go, come to the studio. We're gonna make your first record. So I came and it was fun. It was really fun. My music is a sort of meeting of impressions and bits of memories or music or noise and sounds and maybe lots of collage and kind of shocks of different kind of styles together. The response around Smash, the record, the sort of hype thing, I don't really care about this. It's something you have to generate when you release something. But then in the long term period, it doesn't mean, you know, you don't know how hype a Rolling Stone record was when it came out. You don't really care. So what stands in time is not about, you know, how hip it was when it came out, or, you know, so how many super hype records that you forget maybe 8 or 9 months after. So I'm not so focused on that. Have you really thought about utopia? I try to discover new softwares more and more, and the more I've discovered softwares, the less I want to use them. I think I learned how the different ways you can process a signal, an audio signal, or generate some signal. I learned some rules of this by trying on my own with the more different interfaces, because it's always kind of like the same, but you can find millions of different, like, they call plugins, you know. This is the thing that drives you wild. Now I'm a bit trying to get away from it, because it takes you too much time. Some of the favorite stuff I've been using, it's this thing called Metasynth. It's a, I think, very good software. It's not that new. I mean, yeah, they did a new version, but yeah, I like this software a lot. in terms of collaborations, I mean, I've did a record with Pepe Braddock. I've made some music with Mr. Oiseau and Marc Collin or Tim Paris or Cosmo Brown. I find it difficult to have this balance and being really in this moment and, you know, in harmony to be able to get a record out and being completely satisfied, especially because the way I make a song is pretty unstable. It's not like I have my setup and I can invite someone into it and be like, hey, let's make a song this afternoon. It's too chaotic. I mean, and it's very difficult when I start involving someone into this. To put someone in front of this whole never-ending kind of, you know, thinking like, is this how I want this to sound, or do I really want to be like that, or because I'm kind of going through all these doubt moments and stuff. So to do this with someone, you can't. It's difficult. Until I bleed for thee. This moon is dead, my friends all in the outside tin, all test for intestines. My guts are sheer rejection, fuck you and your affections. I'd rather die a million times than once to your deception. Future projects, I don't know where I'm going, so I think that's what I want to be in this state where I'm discovering and everything is moving, so I'm gonna make a new record this summer when it's hot and everybody's sweating. I'm gonna be working because I haven't done anything the whole winter. I have to do something in the summer. If I wasn't a musician, I think I would be a psychologist and a tennis teacher. Yeah, I think I would go through a sort of like sport therapy and maybe something sexual, like combined together. I would help women to solve that problem by playing tennis and having sex with me. In California. Why? It sounds like a good job, no?